Hello friends, we have already discussed earlier about preamble. Means we know what is the preamble. Preamble means the preface. And it is the beginning part of our constitution. So that is the line comes. Constitution starts by preamble. It means constitution is beginning with the preamble. So the first part of the constitution is preamble. It gives reflection of whole constitution, ideals, goals, mindset of the constitution makers. All things are being discussed and reflected in our preamble of the constitution. But when I am talking about the pillars of the preamble, then it means pillars means the base. Actually, I could say if we are talking about a table, a sofa, chair, usually we see four pillars. But when a table with the three pillars we can see, it is called tripod. And here our preamble is also on the three pillars, means three legs. First is a democracy, second is a socialistic, third is a secularism. So here you understand one thing, that our constitution is based on some important pillars, some important characteristics, some important features, and out of all these are three pillars of our preamble. Okay, now I just read some points given in the preamble. We the people of India, see, we have already earlier discussed the whole preamble. I already read and I have explained it, you know that. But here I am just reading it, which reflect the important part as the objective indicated in the preamble. Just carefully listen. We the people of India, sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic, justice, liberty, fraternity, and equality. See, here the word we the people of India means we have adopted this constitution, which is made by us, implemented on ourselves by us, right? Okay, here some important objectives and goals are also being reflected. The sovereignty, the socialistic, secularism, democratic system, republic, country, justice for all, liberty to all, fraternity with each other. Fraternity means the brotherhood, I've already said. And equality means all are equal to each other. So here some basic goals, objectives, and characteristics are indicated in our preamble. Out of these all, 3 points, as I have said, democratic, socialistic, and secularism are considered as pillars of preamble. So sometime in one line question, the question may ask that which are pillars of preamble, then these are the three words. You have to indicate that democracy, secularism, and socialistic, right? So nothing more to add. Okay, now I'm explaining the first one. Democracy. See, generally you understand the meaning of democracy. Democracy means the people of India are free, according to the constitution, to elect their leaders. No any particular regime by hereditary rule the nation. So in that situation, we the people of India have complete power to take the decision about who will rule over us. That is the first thing you have to remember. Democracy. For the people, of the people, and by the people. The rule is being done. In very easy word. You have already heard and studied in the earlier standard, right? So now the explanation of the word democracy is basically two Greek words, demos and kratos. Demos means people and kratos means power. Means power given by the people to rule over the nation. Here we could understand in that way. Or we can say the country's power is not kept in hand of one person, but instead of that, the country's power to rule will remain in hands of people of India. They will decide that who will rule. So it is important to understand that who will rule over the nation. Here it is said to be that there is a administration of the nation will be controlled by people, and the people's given power to them, they will administrate the nation. So in that situation, all powers are kept in hand of the people. They will decide that who will rule over them. This is the simple explanation of democracy in regarding India. Is that clear? Okay. One thing more. Here we have equality. We have equal justice. And justice means social, economical, and political justice are given to us to take the decision. So in that way, our participation in the rule is equally important for all the people without discriminating anyone on the basis of class, color, race, creed, whatever you want to say. Now, in our democratic country, I could say one thing, that people elect their leaders. So, by the way of casting the vote, with the use of right now electronic voting machine, ultimately the decision is in hands of the people. Is that clear? The legislative assemblies and the Lok Sabha and the representatives sitting in the Lok Sabha are being elected by that way, which is known to be democratic system. So remember, these all people are the part of the executive, and the executive is not having absolute power to take the decision, remember, because the power is with them under some specific limit of cross check balance on each other. So neither any person in the executive is having complete power to rule the nation. Nobody is beyond the law and the constitution in India. So the democracy is reflected in that way by restricting every office bearers of our administration is having limited power to rule over the nation, to control the nation and take decision. Is that clear, my friends? So now you can ask me that any person come to the power, but up to which limit? The limit of the 5 years, he will come to power and he will take the decision. And also the decision is with restriction to be passed by all representatives, then will be signed by our ultimate leader and the supreme leader of the nation as per the constitution is president. So without his signing authority, the any order is not allowed to be passed. So in that way, the government of India is working under the principles established by constitution. So every member of the executive or the government is responsible to answer any question regarding the duties given to them. He is responsible to answer about duties given to them. So in that way, this government, which is elected by the people, is called responsible government. Is that clear? Now you understand one thing, that the democratic government is working on basis of liberty, equality, fraternity, and continuous work to achieve the goal. So in that way, nobody is out of limit, and this limit is prescribed as per the constitution. So the power is ultimately remain with the people to elect their leaders. So in that way, they are free to elect their leaders, and it reflect the power of people in constitution. So the democracy is giving complete power in hands of the people, which they use by electing their leaders. So the constitution of India is rendering some specific fundamental rights to every citizen of India, and this right is given to every person by his birth. So it is called fundamental right. Remember this word. One thing more. Principles of the political direction will work as a parliament, as a member of assembly, as an independent and impartial justice, and as an election commission. The people are coming on the post, are working on any of this power. Again, as a parliamentarian, as a member of assembly, as an independent and impartial justice, as a member of election commission, the people are being appointed, will work according to that. So in that way, our country work as a democratic country in all the manner, and the rest power are stay in hands of people, which reflect the capacity of every person. Now here I want to explain one small question which is given here, but I explain it as a different topic. Adult suffrage. What do you mean by adult suffrage? Actually, you have studied by 8th standard. Adult suffrage means, adult suffrage means any person, a citizen of India, above 18 years of his age, can cast his vote or her vote to his or her own choice about the leader to elect, without any discrimination of caste, class, creed, race, religion, language, gender, education, income, or birthplace. So these are not to be allowed as a reason for discrimination to restrict person from taking his decision about election related rights. So it is essential that a person should be aware that his or her name is in electoral list or not. Electoral list means list of the citizens who have right to vote. If his or her name is in the list, then he can allowed to cast the vote without any discrimination. This is compulsorily given to every person in India and it cannot be denied by any person. Remember this. Okay, now I am going to discuss about the second topic of our pillars of preamble. It is socialistic. See, in our constitution by 1976, by the year 1976, one amendment was made as 42nd amendment in Constitution of India, that is saying that word socialist is added. So it means, here you remember one thing, not only this word, but socialist, secularism, these are the words added in 1976 which were not in earlier our constitution. But here when it is added, then it is necessary to be discussed that what is its importance. So in our constitution directly saying, it is not said that directly they reflect the word, but it is directly been shown in which way that the social revolution come in India. In which way? By the social and economic equality. Also with the aim of welfare state. Welfare means betterment of every person is keeping in mind. So it is called welfare state. Remember this word. So here you understand one thing, that our constitution is taking us towards the social and economic revolution. Revolution of what? Revolution means the process of upliftment of suppressed people of the nation. So in that way, our constitution direct us to social equality, economic equality, political equality, and it is being reflected in our preamble of the Constitution of India. So we all the people is accepting it. Now you understand one thing, socialistic approach is considered as prime feature of the state. See, you have to keep this line in your preparation as one mark. Socialistic is prime feature of the state, and it shows that India is committed to secure social, economical and political justice to all. Means our constitution gives us all kind of the freedom with three kind of the justice: the justice of social approach, the justice relating to economical aspect, and justice relating to political establishment. So we are free to take decision that who will rule over us, and nobody could restrict him. Now here you have to understand one thing. Our country stand with removal of all kind of exploitation and give equal distribution of income, resource and wealth to all citizens of India. Again, I repeat the line. You understand, our constitution destroy and remove or eradicate all kind of exploitation and secure equal distribution of income, resources and wealth to every person in all the way. So you understand one thing, our constitution has given all powers, but in specific limit, because we can't expect that freedom means move anywhere, freedom means to say whatever we want to think, freedom means do whatever we want to do. Everything is allowed, but in specific limitation which we have to accept. We cannot deny for it. Is that clear? Now you understand the last point of this second pillar, that any one of the particular person should not have all power vested in his hands. Instead of that, here equal opportunity is given to all persons relating to social system, also to remove discrimination with every person on basis of economical capacity, means the rich and poor cannot be destroyed, discriminate. But if there is a discrimination within the society about the rich and poor, about the literate and illiterate, about the white color and the black color, all this kind of the discrimination are required to be eliminated or removed. That is the basic goal of our constitution, and so it has been given equality to everyone. Now I want to say only one line about this second pillar, that our constitution is also considered due to this equality. The concept of equality, our constitution is also called to be socialist document. Means our constitution reflect over responsibility of the administration for social equality to be established within all people. Is that clear? So I explain that our constitution is socialistic document, right my friends? So this is the second pillar of our preamble, and now I am moving to the third point, secularism. See, this is a extraordinary word. Why I said extraordinary word? See, in India, not only one religion exists, but 7 to 8 religions exist in India. You think Hindu, Muslims, Christians, Jews, Zoroastrians means Parsis, right? In Sikh, Jains, Buddhist. Now you think the 8 religions exist in India. It does not mean that who is having the large numbers. Our India is giving equal importance to every religion. So in our constitution in 1976, in 42nd constitutional amendment, the word secular was added. In that way, our constitution is saying that India is secular nation, and secular nation means India can never relate the administration with any particular religion, but instead of that, our administration of India will give equal importance to all religion. So it is said that India is not following any particular religion, but India is considered to be secular nation. So it does not mean that people of India cannot support any religion. It is the religious freedom that to which religion we as an independent person wants to support. See, our president, our prime minister, different chief ministers of different states are supporting as a person to any religion. But when they are taking oath as the constitutional office bearer, then they are bound to behave in term of the secular power having person. So they cannot support as the office bearer of the administration of India to any specific religion. Okay, as a person they support to any religion, it is their own faith to any religion. Nobody could restrict it. But to support whom, it is not in his power to take the decision. So the country not include to any particular religion activity in administrative level. So India is also not discriminating people on basis of any religion. See, other countries we can see, I'm not giving any name, but we can see at the time of the partition, other country have today 2.2 to 3% minority. At that time they were more than 20 to 30% minority. Means when the country divert to any specific religion, their religious behavior will change, even for the administrative people also. But in our country we can't say that. Our country is giving equal importance to all religion. We have not given specific support to any one religion. We have not neglected any religion by our administrative office bearers. But instead of that, we support every religious activities as a person, but not by the administration. The country gives equal opportunity for the job, equal political rights to all citizens without looking to religious discrimination. So in that way, the secularism become a part of our basic foundation of constitution and mandatory feature of our constitution. See, I use the word mandatory feature of our constitution. Here I want to indicate two principles. Sarva dharma samadrashti means our constitution is looking to all religion in equal manner. And second, sarva dharma samabhav, the feelings for every religion is equal in our constitution. So no particular religion is encouraged by any state. or the state administration will not encourage any particular religion's activity, but they will support everyone. Neither any kind of the prohibition may reflect in the administrative level to any citizen in spreading of any religious activity by any person. So our government is not restricting us to do our religious activity, but every activity should be required to be under the limitation of constitution. It is ultimate clear aspect. Is that clear, my friends? So I have explained here about pillars of preamble of Constitution of India, right?